Hey everybody, happy to see you guys. How is everyone doing? I am so grateful for your feedback and comments, and some of you contacting me in person, and we working on certain things. I want to apologize for some people that I'm not able to answer. You're on my list. If something is super important, please write me again. My mailbox is full, and sometimes things get lost, and I'm just really busy, which is a good thing because I'm able to help you. I am making more videos. I'm researching topics, and of course I have, you know, things that I'm doing. I have my other business and so forth. So today, let's talk about some heartbreaking situations and how to don't get stuck in them for too long. You know, we are all human. We all have our ups and downs. We all facing life, and we are only capable to control. Don't really like the word control, but I would say this: we are only responsible to for our emotions and actions and so forth. So, do you really need to know why somebody left you? Do you really need to know the reason? I'm currently talking to several people, you know, talking, meaning we having some sessions, and we're trying to figure out, you know, what path to take, you know, what's best thing to do. I can totally understand how sometimes when looks like things are going great and everything is wonderful, and then all of a sudden the person change. And that can be very dramatic. It can cause all kinds of pain and heartbreak. By the way, guys, have you ever thought that pain and suffer are pretty, they're different things? And if you would like to dive in with me a little bit, I'm happy to share with you some insight on this, because we are talking today about painful situation, about when you are lost, when you're not sure what to do, and you're just so much in pain you can't breathe. So pain is something that happens, and it happens all of a sudden. Let's say we didn't expect something really hurt us. Maybe it was, you know, a situation with somebody we are in relationship with, and it happened, like, you know, we have this expression in Ukraine, like a snow on your head, like boom, you know, it happens, you are in shock, you are in pain. So that's pain. Suddenly something changes, something you aren't ready for. You know, I often say a knife in your heart, because, you know, when I'm hurting, people who I do not care about can't really hurt me, you know, and I think a lot of you can relate. So, you know, don't waste your energy, and I hope you guys are like that too. But people who I care about, people who I'm close with, you feel, of course, more sensitive. So that feels like a knife in your heart. So that is pain. Now, suffer is something different. Suffer is when you aren't ready to let the pain go. When you understand, for example, relationship, something doesn't work, something had changed, things seem to not be working out, your partner wants to leave, or he or she left, and first, you know, you are in pain, you are in shock, you know, first hour, first moment, first day. But then what happens? If something happens that we cannot change, you know, we cannot pull this person and, you know, put a robe around them and be with them. What is the point of that? So, what do we do? A lot of us do everything to stay in that pain. So, we choose to turn pain in a consistent suffer. So do you guys know what I'm talking about? I'm sure that you do. And so therefore, it's really your choice. I made a video about being ready for things. You know, only when you are ready, you are ready for suffer. I know it might sound very strange, but somehow you choose to stay in that pattern. You don't want to change anything. You keep your things. You water her flowers. You know, she left, you know, 3 months ago or 2 years ago, but you keep yourself in that place. So you keep over and over again, you relieve that painful situation. Does that make sense to you? When we know that we cannot change something, through pain, through tears, we have to just accept it. There is no power in the world to make somebody like you, to make somebody be with you. And sometimes we do break up when we still love each other. I totally understand that and totally witness that. Sometimes we break up for silly reasons, for the reasons of pride, some circumstances. We truly and deeply love each other. But here is a thing. When you truly love each other and you know that the other person does love you too, let them go. That's another reminder that when you truly love somebody, you happy for everything that's happening in their life, and you kind of have to let them go if that's what they choose at the moment. And then, you know, if they never came back, if they never come back, they have never been yours. But if they will come back after they took some time off, after they took that break, God knows. You know, I'm talking right now about some kind of drama situation. Maybe they had some unresolved issues with themselves. Or maybe they have personal circumstances that they couldn't be with you. So if you love them very much, regardless, you let them go. You just let them go. You open the door. I'm realizing the door should be always open. If somebody wants to leave you, there is no reason to try to hold on to them. So the point is, if you let them go and they come back, you keep them. You keep them forever. Why I'm saying this? Because it's true. You know, sometimes that's how things work. When we stop holding on, when we stop grabbing on somebody, so the person don't have enough of oxygen even to breathe, we are grabbing on them so hard. They need some time on their own to think, to decide. And you want them to come back because it's their decision. You know, maybe they realize something. Maybe, you know, sometimes we depend on other people. You know, maybe their family against you being together. Maybe you had to break up because you live too far away. Maybe some other things happens, but you know, usually some realization, important realizations, they come to you when that person isn't around, because you have time to think, you have time to soul search inside of you, and this when things become clear. I'm not talking about some back and forth drama. I'm talking about when there are some heavy circumstances or long distance relationship or something like that. Absolutely, you have to let the person go. Don't sit there and hope that they come back. Do your own thing. I absolutely, by the way, do not suggest that you let them go and you sit there and just like waiting for every sound. No. If they want to go, you open the door for them. You know, there is no other option, really. There is no other option. You can't you can't put them in prison. And the more you push, the more they will try to get out from it. So meanwhile, while you know, you have to let them go, you do your thing. You know, maybe your relationship wasn't working out because you were too instant in the other person. Instant meaning you were not even living your life. You were so concentrated on another person that they get real tired of you. So pay attention to yourself. Start doing something that you really love. Trust me that there are a lot of things you can do. I'm not recommending, you know, immediately jump also in some other relationship, but give yourself a little break and start socializing. People, you know, good people around you, kind of like therapy. It's the best therapy. We enjoy the communication. The communication between us human bring us the most joy, regardless even these people are your gender, opposite gender, man, woman, kids. We have to create some good connections because we have to basically refocus. But you do this when you realize you want to feel better. The first thing you have to understand that it's your responsibility to make yourself feel better. I talk about this all the time. So yeah, and answering the question, no, you don't need to know why the person left you. You know why? Because that's not about you. In many ways, in many circumstances, when the person doesn't explain anything, when there is some mystery, you can dedicate half of your life to figure out why they left you, or you can move on and enjoy your day. Which one you choose? Yeah. I mean, if you have time that you want to waste, you can make a research, you know, hire somebody, talk with their friends. But does it really matter if the person decided to move on? Does it really matter? No, it doesn't. Because the reason also can be very strange. And you would know that reason, and then you would start judging yourself from that perspective. You don't need this extra information. You really don't. You can do just fine without it. Trust me. Somebody made their choice. Something wasn't right for them. Maybe they made you a favor. Very often, we get this hang on a relationship, it was totally wrong for us. In 100%. Almost, when people live in you, they're making you a favor. Yeah. And some of you know what I'm saying. You go through some suffering, it's painful, but they're making you a favor because they're doing it for you. They do not play this game as if things are going well. It's not working out for them. They leave you so you have space for something better in your life. Yeah. You know, I'm just gonna share my experience a little bit. Right now, talking about some friends, actually, like really close friends in Ukraine. When some of my friends kind of, you know, left my life, or I always felt relief. Because in some ways, maybe I couldn't be myself with them. Maybe I was doing kind of too involved in their life, so when they would leave, I would have like this relief, like somebody took the weight off my shoulders. And it was so surprising for me because I thought I enjoyed them so much. So often, if somebody don't want to be with you and they take an action, tell them thank you. You don't want to be with anybody who do not want to be with you. And when the person do want to be with you, they see no obstacles, they see no circumstances, nothing matters. So why to spend your days and nights in pain when life is going on and the first person you need to fix is you, and then everything else will come along. So we have to learn how to be happy on our own, and when we do, the whole world opens up, we make great friendships, we attract beautiful people, we make connections, and we create another beautiful love. But the thing is, you have to be a happy person. You just have to be a happy person. It all starts inside. Oh my God. That's another super long video. But I just want to wish you the best. If you're going through breakup, do everything that makes you feel better. Don't dig too much, don't dwell too much. See how you can turn the situation to some benefits. If you are, you know, writer, singer, write some songs. Do something creative. You know, somebody said, I think it was Meryl Streep, turn your broken heart into art. Create something. You cannot help those emotions. Let them out. Create something beautiful and start over again. Move on. Start fresh. And you don't have to know any reasons, because you have a life of your own. Thank you.